If you look at asteroids or if you look at the moon, you'll see this layer of regolith covering the surface. So it's this fine particles, fine dust that covers the entire surface. So what's happening is the solar system is very dynamic, and we have asteroids and meteoroids moving around and impacting different bodies. So the surface is getting bombarded all the time. So you have this fine layer of fragments on the surface. So why would we want to study it, right? And why would we want to study it on the space station? There's a lot of interest in one day sending astronauts to asteroids, for instance. And we have already sent a lot of robotic missions to asteroids and plan to send more. And so every time we visit these asteroids, we learn more and more. And there's very diverse bodies of asteroids. Every asteroid seems to be different. And so we need to understand how to interact with the asteroid surface. So if you're going to anchor to the surface of the asteroid, for instance, you need to understand how to interact with the regolith. So asteroids are pretty small bodies, and so they have actually microgravity levels of gravity. And so this is actually what you find on the space station as well. There's four experiments, and each one is a tube. So it's a clear polycarbonate tube about the size of a Pringles can. And so inside this tube, we have the asteroid simulants. And so this is what we're actually studying. And so the main piece of data that we're getting is the movement of these particles. So we have a camera looking at each of these tubes. Over the course of about a year that cassette one will be up there, we'll get this basically time-lapse imagery of the particles moving. And so we're looking at the long-term effects of microgravity and what's happening to the movement of the particles. Also, something that we have on asteroids is vacuum, right? So we want to expose our experiments to the vacuum of space. So we actually have our facility hooked up essentially to a port to space. We did cassette one, but the idea is that Hermes will be open to other investigators. So cassette two, cassette three, cassette seven, these will be other researchers that will apply to use Hermes to do research on asteroid regolith and granular material investigations. And we think that ISS is a wonderful place to study asteroid regolith, to study lunar regolith, regolith in general. So we're excited about the opportunities that Hermes will bring for researchers in the future.
Subscribe for more space.